if you have decided to write the US Emily exams and you have gotten your materials ready, or you are still thinking about getting these materials ready for the US Emily exams, then the strategies that I'm going to talk about in this video is something that would help you to increase your scores within a very short time. My name is Jerry. If you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing to our channel. Also go through our videos and then you'll see some that will help you. If you are a returning subscriber, also I'll say thank you for coming back to our channel. Please comment on our videos and also subscribe and hit the notification bell so that any video that we post in the future, you will have access to it and you'll also be notified. So the first thing that we want to tackle is, when do you want to start prepping for the USMLE? Once you've gained access to the med school, once you've been admitted, and you think that the USMLE is something that you're going to consider or you're going to sit for in the future, then on day one of your admission is when you should start prepping for the exams. So for example, when you start your biology class or you start your basic sciences classes, then you want to also be reading the clinical aspects of whatever is being taught in school, and also you want to be applying them on USMLE QBanks, and in that way you'll be able to integrate whatever is being taught in the classroom, and also you'll be applying it on the USMLE style questions, and then you'll get familiar with it before you get to your Med 2. Or if you're an IMG, when you start early, by the time you finish your school and getting ready actually for the exam, you will have covered a lot of topics, and then you have covered a lot of concepts also. So the first thing is to begin studies for the USMLE as early as possible. Now, before any official studies begin, make a schedule. You need to make a schedule that includes breaks and also time to eat, like your days off. And then like you also have to know, like include like when to take practice tests, when to read. So you just make a comprehensive schedule for yourself. And studies have shown that people who study according to like a fixed schedule are able to improve their scores faster than people who have no plan at all. So it's schedule is one of the things that help students to improve their scores very well, so that you are learning according to a particular direction. Now, in making schedules, you can make your personal schedules. You can also go online and look for people's schedules that have helped them in the past, and then you just redesign it to suit yourself. And that is something that is very important to do. So schedules are very, very important. Now, that brings us to the next point, which is practice tests. So one advantage of the practice test is that it helps you to have to practice whatever exam whatever is going to show on the exams. For example, practice test gives you the ability to work according to a time, like to take tests according to whatever time the USMLE is going to allocate. So if you're taking a practice test like that is 40 minutes, and so if you're taking four blocks, just like the NBME does, you're taking four blocks, and these blocks are timed according to whatever you will see on the real deal, then like a student who has done many of these tests will feel more comfy on the real deal versus a student who took no test at all. So I will say that you want to take as many practice tests as possible, and this practice test should be in a timed mode. Also, people have conflict of this idea. So timed mode works for some people, and then the untimed mode works for some people. But what I'll say is that everybody should do some number of timed mode questions. So for example, if you are just studying, then you can work in a non-timed mode. But then if you are taking monthly assessments, if you're taking NBME, you want to do it according to time so that you simulate exactly what's on the exams. Now, the next thing is that complete as many practice questions as possible. People suggest that you do between 7,000 and 10,000 questions before you finally sit for the exam. In this way, you would have seen a lot of concepts and then explanations to those concepts. Also, you would have come across different ways by which the same concept could be tested. So it's something that you want to do as many questions as possible. So some people decide to just read the first aid, and then if you just read the first aid and you don't apply them on questions, then you are not able to tell if the question is asked in a different way, whether you can be able to fish out the answer that they want. So you really want to do as many practice tests as possible. And one of the best Q banks is the UL that everybody does, and it's very good. The NBME is the second best one. So you want to do all the NBMEs if possible, but if not, then you want to do the new ones. The old ones are also available that you can do offline, and they also help. UWorld, it's online, you can subscribe. Some people also do it offline, but the online, the advantage is that UWorld is still doing review of their questions and editing it, and also their answers, they are adding more images and more explanations. So doing it offline helps better than not doing it. Doing it online helps better than doing it offline. So you can also consider that, but then everybody and their budget, and then we understand that all the fingers are not equal. So that is something pardonable. But then at the end of the day, you want to do as many questions, as many Q banks as possible. USMLE RX is one that is also very good. AMBOSS is another that people do. So you want to consider which one to do. And let me chip in this quickly. So usually what is recommended is that you do a first pass of UWorld, and then whatever you get, you review your incorrect, then you drop UWorld and then go to another Q bank. And then when you do, for example, AMBOSS, later on you can come to UWorld and do your second pass. In that way, you saw what UWorld had, then you saw the AMBOSS side of it, and also you come back to UWorld, and now you really understand what questions that you missed initially. So yes, you want to do Q banks. Now, be sure to do as many full length practice tests as possible in a test-like setting to ensure that you are finishing blocks that are allotted in like 60 minutes, and then prepping your body for a long test day. So like what some people do is that if they're doing NBMEs, they will do let's say 4 blocks of NBME or 3 blocks plus the NBME on all on the same day, so that you are doing 8 blocks on one day. Then in the exam, you are doing 7 blocks. So that means that you, in a day, you can sit for longer and you don't get fatigued. So, and then they say practice makes perfect. So you want to do all these things, and that would really help you. Now, in these practice sessions, what you want to do is that you want to take scheduled breaks also, just like the on exam day. Like in the on exam day, some people can decide that they want to do like 3 blocks continuous, and then take maybe 20 minutes break or 10 minutes break, come back and do 2 and take another break, and come back and do another 2 and take another break. That will make 7 blocks. But then what I did that worked practically for me was that I did the first 2 blocks back to back. Then after each block, I took about roughly like 10 minutes break between each of the blocks. So I'll go eat, come back, then put eye drop on my eyes, and then do the block. Then when I finish, I'll go out again, eat something, put some eye drops again, because my eyes hurt like when I look on the screen for long. So yeah, it's something that you want to also think about. Try to practice what you are going to face in the exams before you go into the exam. Now, the most important thing that I'm going to say is you should study what you don't know. Now, many a times people are misled by, or they want to feel comfy, or they want to feel good about themselves. This exam is not like that. Like, you don't want to just be so comfortable and then you'll be blind to what you don't know. So you want to spend time learning what you don't know. The things that you know, lay them aside. You can review them from time to time, but learn the difficult concepts that you don't know. Learn those ones, and that is how come you grow, or your scores will what be growing over time. So please, I will say, learn things that you don't know. In learning things that you don't know, it could also be like according to the subject. So subjects, for example, if you're someone who is not good at biochemistry, you want to start learning biochemistry very early in your step. If you're someone who is not good at pathology, then pathoma should be your friend from day one. So, and then you have to work on those areas that you are not good at. So that is very important. Now, this can also apply to the Q bank. So when you're doing the Q banks, you get some questions wrong, and then at the end they give you a total score, and then they give you areas that you are weak at. Focus on those areas, because whatever you are getting on the Q banks during your prep, if you don't work on the incorrect, or you don't work on the weak areas, then you are going to take the same thing into the exam, and you don't want to do that. So study what you don't know. That helps better than studying only what you know, and you will not be growing in your scores. Now, another thing is, you want to study with a friend. Like a friend, I don't mean someone I mean like you want to get a study buddy. Okay, you want to get a study buddy that shares the same aspiration as you, a study buddy that is also determined just like you, so that you don't want a study buddy who will study with you this week and next week will take time off for family and leave you hanging on your own, then come back at their own time. But you want a study buddy that, if both of you have a study schedule, then both of you are going according to that schedule, and then both of you will grow together and progress together. And sometimes, for example, you don't want somebody whose learning style does not suit you. So you can try as many people. One way to get a study buddy is you go to Facebook groups and then type in the groups, in the USMLE study prep groups. You type in, hey, I want a study partner. I'm at this stage of study. My exam in 6 months. So you get someone whose exam is also in 6 months. If your exam is in 3 months and you want rapid review, then you want someone whose exam is also in 3 months, so that person also studies the same way with you. You all do the rapid review together, and then your goals and objectives are the same. Therefore, it will help you to improve your score. So study with a friend. Now, apply the mnemonics in the first aid, and then like you can also search Pixarize for more mnemonics. Those mnemonics, what they do is that they help you to like to remember a lot of things that you shouldn't learn separately. So for example, if you know let's say the causes of anion gap metabolic acidosis, then you don't want to just learn each of them separately. But then if you know the concepts, then with the mnemonics you can memorize all of them just with the mnemonics. So appreciate the mnemonics in first aid. Learn those that you can learn. You can make time for them. Some people decide that during the day they'll just allot some time to mnemonics and recite mnemonics. What I was doing is that some of my mnemonics were in a song form. So when after studies and then it's time to go to bed, the last 30 minutes from 11 to 12, what I'll do is I'll just come to the living room and then be singing, and then sing them over and over. So if I keep singing something that I don't know, and I sing it for like 1 week to 2 weeks, it's going to stick in my head. It's going to be like a song. So things that are hard for you, go to YouTube, find their songs, like those autosomal dominant, autosomal recessive. Like there are a lot of conditions, like you can't just know them like that unless you find a way to know it. So I prefer learning them according to a song, and that helps me, and they've all stuck in my mind. So that is it. Now, get breaks between your studies. Breaks are very important to relax the brain, to relax the body, and then you can go out, exercise, like walk with friends, talk with family. It's all important. So don't just be reading like 24/7. Get breaks in between your studies. Now, if you're taking your test, focus your prep on areas in which you did not excel. Fortunately, the score report is something that is available for you to use to tell where your scores are not really good. So thank you for watching this video. I hope this helps somebody who is prepping for the exams. And I also hope that in the future, we'll come back with more contents for you. Please subscribe and share with your friends. I want to encourage you that yes, you can do this. One example that I always use that encourages me is that, for example, when I was in primary school, my seniors who were in middle school will tell me, hey, this is, my seniors who are ahead of me would tell me their subjects are very difficult. But then when I get to that level, I'm able to cross. Then when I get to my seniors level, let's say I get to high school, those who are at a different class ahead of me will tell me their class is so difficult. Maybe their teacher is so difficult. But then anytime we get to those levels, we are able to cross. So I want you to know that this level also you will cross. You will cross step one, you will cross step two, you'll take step three, you're going to residency, and then you'll become a doctor and be practicing. Trust me, you can do this, okay? Just keep studying every day, pray to your maker, and then know that, yes, you can. Peace out. Thank you.